Our second speaker for today is Dr. Praveen Bhatia, MS, FRCS, and Medical Director at Bhatia Global Hospital and Endosurgery Institute. He is one of the celebrated laparoscopic surgeons practicing in the medical specialization for many years in Delhi. He is proficient in identifying, diagnosing, and treating various health issues related to medical field. The doctor has the requisite knowledge and the expertise not just to address diverse set of ailments but also to prevent lethal conditions. In today's session, he will be delivering a talk on mental health. With the growing number of people experiencing a decline on their mental health, society is becoming better equipped to respond to our needs. However, the stigma around mental health illness still is prevalent in the society, and hence there is a need to overcome the stigma where a distinguishing characteristic or a personal trait is thought to be a disadvantage, which further leads to discrimination. One can witness rampant reluctance to seek treatment, lack of understanding by family and friends, fewer opportunities for work, school, or social activities, catering to the needs to create awareness. In today's session, Dr. Praveen Bhatia will be enlightening us on the topic of mental health. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much. At the outset, I must thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to speak, one, and speak on the topic of mental health, though my focus would be on positive mental health. And in this, I will be focusing on that how to remain calm and how to remain positive. In the introduction, I must thank Professor Pawa and Mani Manjari for giving this opportunity, one. Second, I must tell you that I am a surgeon. I am a laparoscopic surgeon, bariatric surgeon, robotic surgeon at Sir Gangaram Hospital and Bhatia Global Hospital. I do surgeries day in and day out, but believe me, I don't treat patients of mental health. But any patient, any person who comes in contact with me definitely gives me a compliment later on that you have given us so much of positivity. Your positivity is infectious, is contagious. And believe me, my tagline on WhatsApp also is staying positive, and I will surprise you by my positive energy level. So I bring greetings from Institute of Minimal Access, Metabolic and Bariatric Surgery, Sir Gangaram Hospital, and from Bhatia Global Hospital and Endosurgery Institute. I must specially welcome all those MBA students, BTech students who are joining or who have joined, and those students who are passing out. I have been told by Ms. Manjari also that there are students who need such kind of positivity so that they are able to make a difference in the life of so many people. And I would suggest to them, and I would definitely request them, that anything lies within. The happiness lies within. The enemy also lies within. And it is all about finding the calm in the chaos. Many times, you would have heard people telling, "Sir, sorry, sir, I came late because there was a lot of traffic on the way." But I always say, do not curse the traffic. You are the traffic. If you were not in the traffic, obviously you would not have been delayed. So our thinking is, please do not believe in cursing others. Plan your life in such a manner that you are able to tackle the stress within your own self. You are highly educated, B.Tech. To get into a B.Tech, to get into a MBA degree, it is not an easy job. I know that. Both my sons are postgraduates. I know that how tough or how easy is to go in for these kind of courses. So our thinking is that if you are not able, you means you can understand me also, if we are not able to tackle the stress, that means we have failed somewhere. And again, I would say that adversity introduces a man to himself. I will give this presentation of approximately 1 hour with some stories. And stories, for example, the story is that there was a young MBA graduate and he was working in a company and he was getting ready for the office when suddenly his daughter came onto the dining table, and when he was taking a cup of tea, she shook the table and the coffee or the tea went on to his suit. And then can you imagine the cascade of events started? He started blaming his wife. First, that you do not know where to keep the cup of coffee, a cup of tea. You should have kept it at a slight distance. And then if this daughter, you know that she is a young child, if she had come also, the coffee or tea would not have been spilled on me. So they started fighting. And after some time, can you imagine, the wife also reacted and then told that I am not going to drop the daughter to the school. And can you imagine that Mr. So-and-so had to change his clothes and then had to take the daughter into his car and then drop. When he was dropping the child at the school gate, he said, beta, bye. But can you imagine, daughter also did not respond, did not react, did not wish, and she just jumped out of the car and went straight into the gate of the school. He was surprised that every day she would definitely say goodbye, bye, have a good day and whatnot. But today, because she was having the feeling that my father and my mother, both of them have fought in the morning, so why should I give this feeling? And she straight away went into the school. Later on, when he reached his office, can you imagine, the gatekeeper of the office, he said that, sir, today you are coming late and the chairman has asked for it for you many times. So please leave the car and go to the chairman's office. He goes to the chairman's office and then the chairman says, you are late. Why are you late? You should not have come late. He said, sir, there was some problem, some tea or whatsoever. He says, no, every time, whenever I call you, you always give excuses. And this should not happen. If this is the way, then you're not going to serve for long. And obviously he had to come out. Once he came out, then he started bombarding all his subordinates. And later on in the evening, when he started for his home, then he was thinking, what had happened? What was the lesson? He started thinking that had he responded and not reacted, it would have made a difference. If the tea had spilled on his suit, if he had politely told his wife that, I'm sorry, you had placed the tea here, but it has spilled, so let me take a fast change and then we go to drop the daughter. But he had reacted. So lesson of the story, which I especially want to give to my younger children or younger colleagues, that respond, never react. One should always learn that if one has to tackle a stress, then one should respond and never ever react. And again, in last 2 years, all of us have seen that so much of stress was there. Yes, at every level, the stress was there because of the COVID era. But the students could not go to the college. The students could not go to the school. Parents could not earn what they were earning before. But if we have not learned in these two years, that first and the foremost thing is calmness of mind, that we have to remain calm. And this is what is stoicism. I would have loved that if it was an interactive session, but it's fine. Stoicism is stone-like calmness means that I would just take your attention to Thomas Alva Edison. All of us must have heard the name of Thomas Edison. Can you imagine in December 1914, when the influenza pandemic was also on, one century back, when the people had realized the importance of masks at that time. So the Thomas Alva Edison was an inventor. He had invented bulb. His factory got fired. And there was a fire in the factory and there were many offices close by. And can you imagine his son, Charles, was searching for Thomas Alva Edison, that where is the father gone? The factory is on the fire. And after some time, father came out of the burning office and he told Charles, go ahead, call your mom. Call your mom. And Charles was also surprised that all the factories are on fire. And it is the fire because it had so many chemicals in the fire, in the office. So much of fire was there. And Thomas Alva Edison is so cool and so calm. And he's asking for, call your mom. He says, why? He says, Thomas Alva Edison says, tells Charles, she will never ever find such a situation in her life. It is a spectacular scene that one can see so much of fire is going on. So she should be called. And would you be surprised? Charles went and called his mother and they carried on seeing the fires in the offices. Anyone, everyone of us would have responded, would have reacted in a different manner. But by early morning, when the fire stopped, Thomas Alva Edison called all his employees, though there were no casualty in that fire, so called all his employees in one of the park, and told them, yes, all my mistakes, the previous mistakes have been washed off. And now there is a value in disaster. They have been burnt up. Now we can start anew. Means we are going to establish another office. And he requested one of the persons, please find out where shall I get the machines? Another person, where shall I get the office? And he called A, B, C, X, Y, Z, so many people on the dais, on the stage or in front and asked one of them that please find out where shall we get the money from? So what I mean to say, crisis will be there. Crisis definitely. And as our Prime Minister also says, and in as many words, धूप में निकलोगे सफर में निकलोगे तो धूप तो होगी ही सफर में निकलोगे तो धूप तो होगी ही तो व्हाट आई मीन टू से वंस यू आर ऑन अ जर्नी ऑफ लाइफ यू विल फेल यू विल हैव लॉट ऑफ चैलेंजेस यू विल हैव लॉट ऑफ आई वुड से दैट रिलेशनशिप व्हिच विल ब्रेक आल्सो व्हिच विल गो ऑन आल्सो सो थिंकिंग इज that please remain calm. Please respond. Don't ever react. And if I am able to take out your stress, if I am able to give this piece of mental health to you, my job is done. What I mean to say, in last century, so many deaths have occurred. We have seen in World War I, 22 million deaths. In Spanish flu, 50 million, and so on and so forth. In all the wars also, but they have passed. So the thinking is, this too shall pass. This phase of depression, this phase will pass, and one should definitely make sure that we are affected, but we should take the advantage of the adversity. For example, if you are not able to attend the colleges, if you are not able to attend the classes, then online, Zoom business, Zoom classes attendance has increased. So this is the taking the advantage of the adversity, taking the advantage of the opportunity. So please make sure that we do not have any mental stress. We should know how to come out, and one should have a belief in oneself. If we do not have belief in oneself, then we will every time, anytime, we will be cursing the darkness. I always tell my younger colleagues, especially in Gangaram Hospital and Bhatia Global Hospital, don't curse the darkness, light a candle. And one candle is enough. One candle will light so many candles and change the way the game is played. Anyone who can think about who is this player? This is Michael Jordan. And Michael Jordan had also told, when he was a very young boy, he was from a very poor family. And can you imagine, his father called him once. And he said that, Michael, you take this shirt and you sell it off. And he was surprised. Michael was surprised that how can I sell a shirt which has been worn by my father, which has been worn by my brother, and now I have also worn it. How can I sell this shirt? It was an old shirt. But he says, no, go ahead, sell it, because we need money. So Michael Jordan carried on thinking. And after thinking for some time, he went to the metro station, and then he was standing outside and he carried on selling. After cleaning the shirt and ironing the shirt, he carried on telling, shirt for $20, shirt for $20, shirt for $20. And can you imagine, ultimately he could sell the shirt at $20. And father was surprised that he was thinking that he would earn $1 or $2 out of this old shirt, but how come that he has got $20 in his pocket? He said, young man, young boy, young Michael, excellent. You have done a great job. Now, another shirt. He gave him another shirt. And this time, he said that, please sell it at $200. So Michael was surprised that, how can I sell it at $200? I thought that shirt would cost $1 or $2. I have been able to sell at $20, but how can it be sold at $200? He went and he carried on thinking for 1 week. He cleaned the shirt, ironed the shirt, and then took it to the Broadway theater. In New York, if you have visited, there is a theater which is called as Broadway Theater. And Farhad was the actress who was there to do a premiere show. So the poor boy, the Michael, was standing outside with that shirt. And can you imagine that he could sneak into the auditorium of Broadway Theater, and he requested Farhad that, is it possible that you give me an autograph? The actress was also surprised that a poor child, how does he know, and a little child, how does he know that my autograph carries so much of value? So many people were coming. So she said, yes, I would do it. Michael said, I have a request. Please give the autograph on this shirt. And she did it. She obliged him. And as soon as the autograph was there on the shirt, he came out of the theater, of the Broadway theater, and started shouting that autographed shirt, $200, $200, $200. And can you imagine? The auction started and he got $800 of that shirt. Why? Because it was signed by the actress. So why? What is the lesson of the story? Lesson of the story is believe in yourself, become a cerebral laborer, carry on thinking, and never ever feel that this is the end of the story. We should be mentally strong. We should always be thinking positive. We should always be thinking about the possibilities. The optimism should be there and not the pessimism is there. And can you imagine, he had written in the end also, when he was the champion and champion for so much or so many years, that I have missed more than 9,000 shots in my career in basketball. I have lost almost 300 games, 26 times. And again, I have failed many times, but spirit was that I should not give up. If you also think like this, that even if, for example, you are, this is me playing golf, so never ever give up. Our thinking is life is not about finding yourself. Life is about creating yourself. For this, I would just tell you two words. And two words would mean, one word is called as Meraki. M-E-R-A-K-I. The Meraki means miracles. Anything you do, put your soul into it. Again, I am repeating, it is a Greek word called Meraki. M-E-R-A-K-I. Meraki means anything you do, put your soul into it. Even if, for example, if you are making a cup of tea, then also put your soul into it. Or if you are in the class, in the college, in the exam, in the life, if you put your soul into whatsoever you are doing, you are not going to fail. You are going to be positive. You should always remain positive that I have given my best into it. And if that habit is there right from the beginning of your college days, school days, or college days, or job days, or so on and so forth, then you will never ever repent or regret in your life. One. Second thing is, there is word called as Kaizen. K-A-I-Z-E-N. Kaizen means continuous improvement. Continuous improvement. So carry on thinking that how am I going to improve every day, every minute. And for that, I always tell, especially all my younger colleagues, that one should have that eagerness to learn. Remain a learner. Don't ever become a learned. The day you become learned, you are doomed. So remain a learner. That kind of, I would say, put it in Hindi, vyakulta. Vyakulta hamesha rehni chahiye, so that ultimately you are in a pursuit of constant improvement. You are in a pursuit of giving your best anytime and every time in any job which you are doing. Put your soul into it. I would second this by one of the stories. There was a man who on the seashore, he had a farmhouse. And on the in the farm, as it was on the seashore, lot of waves would come. And tides will come and ebb will go off. And the man wanted somebody to take care of his farmhouse. He would employ the people. But after 1 or 5 or 7, 10 days, the people, the boys, they will say, no, sir, I cannot do it, because lot of waves come in the night and I am afraid of my life. So I will not be able to do the job at your farmhouse. And after a few days, they will leave. He would carry on employing them. He would try to pay them much, but they would leave. So he gave the advertisement in the newspaper that I want some caretaker of my farmhouse, which is just close to the seashore. And one of the persons, very short height persons, came and told, yes, I am ready to work at your farmhouse. He says that, what is your condition? He says, the condition is, I can sleep when the wind blows. I can sleep when the wind blows. The employer could not understand, what do you mean by that? So he said, okay, you are employed and let me give you the job. He gave the job, and maybe 4 days after the job, the night was very much stormy. And then he went to that boy, the employer went to the boy, get up, man, get up. How come you are sleeping? The storm has come and it is just water is going to come into our farmhouse. So get up fast. He says, sir, when I got the job, I told you very clearly, I can sleep when the wind blows and let me sleep. Would you be surprised? The employer went outside and he was cursing this young boy that how could it be when the storm is coming and he says that I can sleep when the wind is blowing, when the wind blows. But when he went outside, he found that whole of his farmhouse was absolutely prepared to take any challenge. All the cycles or all the things were very nicely tied up, fixed up, so that nothing damage would occur. So this young boy had done the job before sleeping. He had put his soul into the job. He had learned that ultimately, when the crisis is there, I should be fully prepared to solve this problem, solve this crisis. So that was the meaning of that I can sleep when the wind blows. Especially for my younger colleagues, younger children, younger students, I would say that please don't repent at the 11th hour. You may die at 10:30. Please do not repent at 11th hour. You may die at 10:30. Means prepare yourself in such a manner that don't wait that when the exam dates will come, then only I will be studying. You should be consistent in studying, for example. You should be consistent in tackling the stresses of life so that at the end, you should not have any regrets or any repentance. And again, for that, one has to develop one own self. One has to develop these soft values. I call these as soft values. That means the teachers would always teach you for a few hours, but these soft values have to be imbibed from your parents also and from your colleagues also. Can you imagine that one can see the 3 Nobel Prize winners in this photograph? Very small photograph, and photograph is of Marie Curie, who had got the 2 Nobel Prizes, only woman to have 2 Nobel Prizes, that is in physics and chemistry. And Pierre Curie was her husband, physics, and their daughter also, and she got it in chemistry. But first time, when Marie Curie was being given the Nobel Prize for physics, when she was nominated, then she said in as many words, I have done a lot of homework, but my husband has also done so much of work. If, for example, if you are giving the Nobel Prize to me alone, then I am not accepting it. But if you are giving to my husband, the co-sharing, then I will accept it. These are called as soft values. means you should always give the credit to whatsoever is being done. And in this photograph, what do you see? I would just tell that this is the bridal waterfall in Peru. It's not what you see, it is how you see. You can take mentally also, how will you tackle the mental status, mental health, is that you should know that how to see. There will be some situations. Again and again, I am reiterating, there will be many situations in life when you will be not able to give your best. But if you see that, if you are able to find out that in what manner I can make it positive, then only you will be able to make a difference. So it is not what you see, it is how you see that is important. Again, especially for those who are doing BTech, who are doing the MBAs, who are doing these professional courses, once you come out of the college, then so much of pressure will be there and you have to work in that pressure. But please don't give up. Have the challenges in your stride and then you will be able to meet them. This is a small frog story. Let's be very honest about it. Why I am complicating my lecture with these kind of stories? Our lesson is, these stories stay for a long time. Even if I carry on telling, or our elders have told us that honesty is the best policy. Yes, we will know that honesty is the best policy, but unless I give a story, then only it gets reinforced in my mind. So this story was that one day the frogs decided that we are going to have a race. For example, on a college day, or maybe 15th August at 7 a.m., we will have a race and we will reach to the top of the mountain. Now, just draw the analogy in this story that you have been given the job and you have to reach the top of the company. Then, or you in the college itself, you have to be on the top. Then, when they announced that on 15th of August at 7 a.m., the race will start, and one has to reach the top of the mountain. Can you imagine what happened? That hundreds of frogs collected, but thousands of people also collected on the side runs. And they were interested. They came to know that there is going to be a race of these daddu or frogs, and they have to reach on the top of the mountain. So let's see, as soon as the whistle blows, the race starts. There were many frogs which were falling. And these cheerleaders, I would put it, or the people who were standing close by, or criticizers, they were feeling very happy that these frogs wanted to reach the top of the mountain. The race has just started and so many frogs are falling down. And they carried on cheering. They carried on speaking so loudly. Yes, go ahead. But from the heart of heart, they were very happy that the frogs are falling off or falling down. But ultimately, one frog could reach the top of the mountain. These cheerleaders were surprised that how could it be that one frog has reached the top of the mountain, whereas all other frogs have fallen off. So they started interviewing the frogs. What happened? What happened to you? The one frog says, "Oh, sir, I am doing so good. Why should I be the topper in the class? I have been getting average marks, and that is fine for me." Another one says, "No, actually, I was running a good race, but my neighbor pushed me down, or he gave a adangi, in Hindi we say adangi devi, so that ultimately I had fallen." But most of the frogs started giving such kind of excuses. But the cheerleaders or the onlookers or the criticizers, they were not happy with the answers. They were much interested in how could that frog reach the top of the mountain. And at that time, they called all the frogs that please find out that how come all of you had a fall, all of you could not reach the top of the mountain, only one frog could reach the top of the mountain. So just find out from him. The frogs had a meeting. They started asking each and everyone, but again, they were not happy with the answer, because that frog who had reached the top of the mountain, who had topped the class, for example, he was just smiling. He carried on smiling. Then they themselves said, no, if you are not able to find out, he is just smiling. Let us find out, the onlookers, the cheerleaders, let us find out how could he reach the top of the mountain. The other frogs started giving excuses again. They said, no, he must be the president's man. He must have bribed some people and that is why he could reach the top. Or he was on drugs. That is why he has reached the top. Or he had taken alcohol and that is why he has reached the top. But no, when they asked the frog who had reached the top of the mountain that how could you reach the top and carry on, and can you imagine, he carried on smiling because he was deaf. So our thinking is that please, for God's sake, close your ears. Don't listen to the outer noises. Listen to your inner voice. I know this is very much, expectation is more from our younger colleagues, because they have to lead a career in which one has to carry on moving. If, for example, again, coming back to the same story of mental stress, if some kind of stress is there, if, for example, you are not having a good affair with somebody, or if you are not able to pass the exam, there will be some situations when you will feel stressed out. But my request to you, especially as parent, especially as a teacher or a doctor or a colleague, you should always believe on harkat mein barkat hai. Harkat mein barkat hai means carry on moving. And that is the, even if, quote unquote, Praveen Bhatia, I always say that even if you are growing through hell, keep moving, because that is the only way you will come out. So thinking is that if you are able to give your best in each and every aspect, you are on a mode of constant improvement. If you are honest to your own self, if you are deaf to others' criticism, if you believe in yourself, then the mental stress will also vanish off. And especially I have collected this story about the Pontiac car. Can you imagine, one of the persons bought the Pontiac car, which was from General Motors. It was quite a costly car. And he complained to the GM, the general manager of General Motors, that whenever I go to buy vanilla ice cream, the car would not start. Car would not start. The complaint started from GM, and then he told his engineers that though it appears to be a frivolous kind of complaint, but let us find out. This is an expensive car, but how can the person who has bought this car can complain that the car is allergic to vanilla ice cream? So he told his engineers, just find out and have a contact with that person. He sent the engineer to the person's home and asked him, what is the challenge? He says that after dinner, every time in the family, we decide. If, for example, if we are going in for vanilla ice cream, I go to the nearby shop, come back, but when I come back to start my car, my Pontiac would not start. But when I go and buy the All-American Sundae, then it will start. When I take any other ice cream, it will start. But when I'm purchasing the vanilla ice cream, it would not start. So the engineer also went along and he's found out that yes, he was right. When he came out of the shop, ice cream shop, after taking vanilla ice cream, the car would not start. So he checked the bonnet, he checked the engine, he checked everything. He could not find a mistake. And when he had gone for some other ice cream, all American banana split or whatsoever, then the car would start. So he ultimately phoned the general manager of General Motors that yes, this complaint is not frivolous. This complaint has value. And so the GM says that please go and get the car checked up at workshop. So car was checked up and they could not find any mistake. But that GM had the principal of the school or the principal of the college, she or he had so much of belief in herself or himself that she said that, that no, our car should not behave like this. So he started his applying his brain and he said that please find out in the engine that there is a wire, there is a pressure carburetor, and in that there can be lock, some lock, and just take care of that lock and change the tubing and the car would start. Can you imagine? The engineers could not find out where was the fault, but the GM sitting on the top, the principal of the college sitting on the top because of the so much of experience in life and so much of thinking that God lies in details, devil also lies in details. So much of thinking was there inside the brain of the GM. So he could find out that if you take off that tubing, which is connecting, because why could he think of this? Because he thought when the person goes to buy the vanilla ice cream, it is available on the counter. It does not take much time and he comes back and the car would not start. But when the person goes to go in for all American banana split, he spends time. It takes time for him to cook, to make the ice cream. Then when he comes, by that time, that vapor lock has vanished. The carburetor has cooled down and now the motor or the car would start. So what I mean to say, at any level, every level, you have to give your best. One, you have to be a thinking person. Two, you should never ever give up. And again, God lies in details. Devil also lies in details. If the head of the institution believes that some challenge must have been there and that is why this complaint is there. In MBAs, can you imagine, once you come out, maybe you work in the hospitals or you work in the companies, if that kind of attitude is there, that you are going to have these problems, but if you have an attitude that I have to solve this problem, I have to solve this challenge, come what may, I am not going to give up, then only you will be able to reach the top of the mountain, one, and then only you will be able to solve all the challenges and make a difference. So my request to you is that please never ever give up. In order to settle the crisis, to settle the mental health, to settle the stresses in life, if you have a habit that I am not going to give up, come what may, the safar mein nikle ho, dhoop to hogi. So if this too shall pass, now you see in this photograph that the frog is catching hold of the neck of the stork and till last moment, it is trying his best to press the neck of the stork so that the ultimate, the stork is dead and the frog will jump out. So our thinking is that this is an attitude. If that kind of attitude is there in you in life, then we would never ever be bereft of success. Our thinking is that yes, if you want to be successful, then fail, double your failure rate. So if you double your failure rate, but if you really learn from your failure, then definitely you will have that kind of attitude and you will always be successful. Our thinking is, as Zig Ziglar had beautifully pointed out, that the real opportunity for success lies within the person and not in the job. Our thinking is that the basic thoughts are that believe in yourself. The secret to success is to start from scratch and keep on scratching. If you keep on scratching, if you carry on doing, believing in yourself, I would just end up, and I would love that you should also have the interactive kind of questions or whatsoever it comes to your mind after this story. This is a story of Charles Blondin. Charles Blondin, he would walk over the Niagara Falls on a tight rope way. And you can see in this photograph that he is carrying a small child on his back and he is balancing. And I don't know how many of you have been to Niagara Falls or have seen Niagara Falls. It is chilly winds which flow and cold water is flowing downstairs. And this man goes from one place to another place on a rocky area and over the waterfall. And he is carrying a child on his back. And he is balancing himself with this kind of rod which he is carrying in on his hand. And can you imagine, once he reaches the other end, people were very happy, thrilled that how could it be that you have reached from one place to another with so much of chilly weather and so much of cold was there, still you were carrying your child onto your back and then also you have been able to cross over on a tight rope. How could it be? So he said that have belief in your own self. So he said, do you trust me? The people said, so much of public had collected. They said, yes, we trust you. We have definitely believe that you will be able to go back also if you want. He says, yes, that was my question. That if I go back, then do you have a belief? Do you have a trust that I will be able to reach the same mountain from where I had started? They said, yes, you will be, because we have seen your skill set. He says, is it possible that this time I do not carry my son on my back, I carry your son on my back? And can you imagine what was the response? Response was, yes, we have a belief, but we do not have the trust. So what I mean to say that this is the difference between the trust and the belief. And again, in Bhatia Global Hospital also, and in Gangaram, my policy of operating the patient, I'm operating day in and day out, is to be trusted is a greater compliment than being loved. So believe me that have the faith, have the trust on your own self, and then only you will be able to make a difference. And again, I would request, especially to my younger colleagues, that please carry on reading the books. And if you are able to read the books, and if you think that every battle is won before it is fought, then only. That means mentally you have to be strong enough. If you are mentally strong, if you are calculating that this is the way I am going to answer my questions, then you will definitely be successful. So request you to go in and go in to read these kind of books, The Art of War, for example, that if you know the enemy and know yourself, you need not fear the results of 100 battles. Thinking is, know thyself, think out of the box. I am not going into the details of these stories, But again and again, I would say that please have a mindset which is positive. Please have the mindset which is thinking out of the box. And please carry on thinking that even if I fail, I will never ever give up. And good is the enemy of great. So please read these kind of books. Attend some positive thoughts to on your colleagues. There are all of you have been given the energy. It is all up to you to harness that energy. You can spend that energy in a negative tone also, and you can spend that energy in a positive tone also. So again, I would have this 12 minutes left in my presentation. So I would not carry on with the stories, but I would end up by saying, edit your life frequently and ruthlessly. It is your masterpiece after all. Please do not give the blame to others. Carry on thinking about whether you are able to make a difference or not. This I would request you, and especially Professor Pava and Mani Manjari and Madam, to ask the younger colleagues, the students, that if they want to have interactive kind of session, it will be more. I will be more than happy to answer for next 11 minutes and 13 seconds. Thank you very much. God bless you all.
Thank you, Dr. Bhartika. It has been a pleasure to listen to your words of wisdom. And I hope students are really eager to have their questions answered from you. So I would not waste their time. Aman sir, can you please unmute the attendees?
Yes, ma'am, I have already unmuted.
Yes. Daksh Khatreja, you can raise your question.
Good, sir.
Yes, Daksh.
Sir, can you please name some more books which we should read for the
veteran? Wonderful. Excellent question. I am so happy that I would request, especially Mani also and Mrs. Pava also, that once they perform well, once, for example, you are selected, then you should be awarding them with books. And such kind of books will definitely go a long way. I would say that Robin Sharma's books are beautiful, wonderful, motivational stories. The Prakash Iyer had written wonderful books. So those kind of books have to be given. Then, as I mentioned, Good to Great, there are so many motivational. Only thinking is that please have that kind of mindset, that the magic of thinking big, for example. This kind of books should be read. Once you start reading those books, once you start sharing among yourselves, definitely your vocabulary will go up, your positive intent will go up, your confidence will go up, and you will be able to make a difference. In this, again, in a small context, Daksh, I would tell you that your thinking should be, I have to make a difference. The person was standing on the seashore. He was throwing the fish back into the sea. Somebody asked him, "What are you doing?" He said that I am making a difference. How can you make a difference? The waves are coming out. So many fish are coming out. So many fish are dying. And how you are just throwing one fish back into the sea. How can you make a difference? He says, I am making a difference in the life of that fish which I am throwing back. So thinking is that please start today. Kal naam kal ka. Kal naam kal ka. Aaj se shuru karo, believe on now, believe on today, and then start reading them. Can you imagine that Bill Gates also reads one book per week? If somebody says that Bill Gates may not be busy, he must have given the power to everyone and anyone, and that is why he's able to do it. No, he had a habit of reading the books right from the beginning. So he says that if you are not able to read a book in 1 week, you will never be literate. You will never be literate. You will always remain illiterate. So please, Daksh, I go and the habit of winning, as Prakash Iyer had beautifully written, the habit of winning. So go ahead and find that book, order on Amazon, and then go ahead and read those books, and you will be definitely different. Power of Now by Eckhart Tolle. The Power of Now by Eckhart Tolle. So many such kind of books will be there. So once you start, the whole of the world will conspire for you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Next, Ekta Agarwal. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Thank you for such an enriching and significant session. Well, my question was, at times, very once in a while, it such happens that someone says something to you and you react to it and you immediately regret that decision. And no matter how much we apologize, we can never get back to what it was. And we know that immediately we know it was not something I wanted to say. So how can we practice that we never get into such dilemmas ever again? How can we practice to not react, but to respond?
What's her name? I couldn't get it.
Ekta Agarwal.
Ekta, excellent question. Excellent question. For that, again, I have a small story. Small story is that one of the person goes to the mall and she finds a cockroach sits on her suit. And when she finds a cockroach, she makes so much of ruckus. She makes so much of noise, call the manager. This is a, such a big mall, so much of expensive things are available. And the cockroach has come on set onto my sweater. And can you imagine that 100 people collected? And at by the time the manager was also coming, what she could do is that she shook the cockroach like this onto some other woman. And that woman also started fighting with her. That how could it be that you have thrown the cockroach on me? And ultimately, so much of the fighting was there that manager came and manager found out that so much of noise is there just because of one cockroach. Now that another woman, he goes to another woman and says, excuse me, takes the paper and the cockroach, throws into dustbin, and that's it, full stop. So what I mean to say, stimulus was the same. One cockroach, and another cockroach. But the response was different. So you have to, you are absolutely right in asking that at that time, take deep breath. Take deep breath and again reinforce your in your mind, I have to respond. I don't have to react. I have to respond. I don't have to regret. I have to respond. I have to not to react. So that will be the policy. And I know it is a very challenging situation. It is very difficult, but many times you will have regrets. But once you pass through that, once you, as I mentioned in the beginning also, it is all about finding the calm in the chaos. So if you are able to calm yourself, then in Hindi, we always say, "Thairav hona bahut zaruri." So if you have the that kind of thairav within you, you will always be in a positive mood. You will always be happy. You will always be spreading happiness, and that will make the difference. Good question.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you.
Sunaina Uppal, you can raise your question.
Hello, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, you are audible.
First of all, this was a great session and quite a motivating one. Thank you for that. Secondly, I have a question. What are the resources made available by the government or various organizations if a student needs to talk to some professional about, like therapy? So what are the resources that are specifically directed for students?
Good question. But again and again, I am not saying that government has to do the job. Again, I am saying you have to do the job. You yourself have to do the job. And if you are positive within your own self, then you will be able to find so much of path. Many times, many of us start blaming the government, the politicians, the whatsoever, whosoever, principals of the school or the other people. That please do not have that habit. Our habit is that I have to be strong within myself. I have to find enemy also lies within yourself. So if you are able to see within your own self, then only you will be able to make a difference in your mental health also. But otherwise, as you know, one can attend the psychiatrist, one can attend the psychologist, one can go to the different specialists. But again, I would say these are just crutches. These are just crutches. You don't have to walk on crutches. You have to walk on your own feet. And you have to ultimately struggle with your own self, with your own brain. And then only you will be in a positive frame of mind. Please, I would say, swear today that I will stay positive, come so, whatsoever it happens. Whatsoever it happens, I will be positive. The corona was there. If it has not taught you that you have to remain positive, it has not taught you that I have to remain positive in my physical health, my mental health, my social health, then you will not be able to make a difference. So please take out those expectations that somebody else will give you positivity. You yourself have to discover that positivity within yourself, and then you will remain calm throughout.
Thank you, sir, for giving us such kind of means addressing all the question and giving an inspiring answer to all this. Sunaina, if you permit, I can answer and I can add on something. Sunaina asked that is the government or institute is providing some extra facility or resources to develop their mental, right? Sunaina, you are the government.
Yes.
You are the institute. Sir said that whenever you are going to respond or reply, first of all, take a breath. So you have to govern yourself. That means you are the government, right? Thank you, sir.
Wonderful. I think she has seconded that. Don't curse the traffic. You are the traffic. You are the traffic. So wonderful answer.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Daksh, you have another query.
Sir, can you please show your email ID again?
Yeah, this is just go back to the slideshow. Yes, definitely. I would request you that I am just giving the last slide of my presentation, and you can see that it is bhatiaglobal@gmail.com. Bhatia Global is the name of the hospital where this is my own hospital, and this is my mobile number 9810008507. Definitely, you are more than welcome. I love the students. I love the younger crowd not because of anything else, but because I feel young when I am with them. And Manjri also knows, I ask them so many questions. Whenever the younger crowd is there, I ask them so many questions that they always are also attracted. That, sir, what is the next question? What a kind of puzzle have you been able to find out? So our request would be, you can bombard with email or WhatsApp, or you can come personally to Gangaram or to Bhatia Global anytime. But please do not ever give up. Remain positive, stay positive. That is the only way to succeed in life. And believe in yourself. Thank you.
Yes. Next is Tisha Satija. Please unmute and raise your query.
Tisha.
Yes, sir. First of all, sir, good morning.
Morning.
Sir, I wanted to ask this question. I have had a person in my life who has been helping me grow for the last 2 years of my life. But for once in a month, there is that moment when I feel that person is toxic for me. Her response or his response is dependent on my actions and just bothering my mental state at times. So should I keep that person or should I get rid of that person?
Good question. But again, answer is very simple. The people are not difficult. They are different. Full stop. People are not difficult. They are different. Don't be judgmental. Let him or her take his own way, the way they want to. But you should believe in yourself. You should have this thought that treat the people as you are rather than as they are. Treat the people as you are rather than as they are. So once that you are able to overcome that obstacle, that why should I be bothered? Why, how can the happiness, the key to my happiness, be in somebody else's hands? It is in my hands. I have to be happy. I have decided to be happy. Full stop. Nobody can stop your happiness. If you start thinking that your happiness is being governed by him or her, you are wrong. You are absolutely wrong. So I always give the example, again a small story, that there was an old woman, 95 years old. Her husband had died long time back. So she decided that now she should go to the nursing home and remain pass of the rest of the life in the nursing home. She reaches the nursing home and the nursing home secretary says, "Madam, you will have to wait for some time. That room is not ready, so you will have to wait." So he said, "Fine, I have decided to be happy. Don't worry about that." After a few minutes, again she comes. "No, madam, actually the person who had to go and vacate the room, he or she has not gone, so it will take more time." She says that, "No, I have decided to be happy. Don't worry, I am happy." And after a few minutes, when she gets the room and the secretary is taking her into the room, she says, "Do you know that what kind of room are you going to get?" The answer was, "Do you think that the room, the stuff in the room is going to make a difference in my life? I have already decided to be happy. Full stop. So how can it be that room's architecture is not good, the TV is not good, and that will make me unhappy? No, I have already decided to be happy." So same thing is, you should always feel that I have decided to be happy. Whatsoever other person is liking it or not, it's fine. I am not living his life or her life. I am living my own life. I have to make the best out of it. That will overcome that kind of mental stress and you will always remain positive. So you decide from today that I have to be happy.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
God bless you.
So being happy is not much simple.
It is simple.
Riya, you can raise your question.
And I would just give you a caution that I have to operate also. Yeah, go ahead.
Aarti ma'am, please summarize now if sir have restriction.
Yeah, I have to do this.
Yes. Thank you so much, Dr. Bhatia. I hope our students are very much fortunate enough to listen to you through your stories, through your examples. It was indeed an interesting session for all of us. Otherwise, there would not be had been so much participation, so much queries from these students. And I can see some students are still raising hands, but due to lack of time, we have to wind up. So students, Dr. Bhatia will certainly join us some other time also on our request. I hope we will be having such an interesting session again later on also. So this was just a beginning and I hope students have got a start of how to be happy, how to study and how to remain calm in adverse situations. Thank you so much, sir.
I assure you that next time I am not going to have any slides. You will have the interactive session and I will carry on answering.
Definitely, sir.
Thank you.
God bless you. Thank you for your time, sir. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.